أفنى الكل ويبقى هو، ليس الباقي إلا هو. الله 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 الله، ما لي رب إلا هو.
This week, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, marked a very important event, and that was on the 10th of Shawwal, marked the birth of the Mujaddid, the great Imam of the Ahl Sunnah, Sayyidi Ala Hadrat Ash-Shah Imam Ahmad Raza Khan Fazl Bareilly radiyallahu ta'ala an. Sayyidi Ala Hadrat Azimul Barakat radiyallahu an is indeed Ala Hadrat. He is indeed Ala Hadrat radiyallahu ta'ala an. And Ala Hadrat is that blessed personality and that Imam that all the Ahl Sunnah know, from the east to the west. People know who is Ala Hadrat Azimul Barakat radiyallahu anhu, especially those that have connection to the Indo-Pak subcontinent. But even more so, the Arab world, great scholars of the Arab world, the mashayikh of the Arab world have also paid tribute and honored Sayyidi Ala Hadrat Azimul Barakat radiyallahu anhu. So the 10th of Shawwal marked the birth of Sayyidi Ala Hadrat Azimul Barakat radiyallahu anhu. We all know that Ala Hadrat Azimul Barakat radiyallahu anhu, subhanallah, the great Imam, Ala Hadrat Azimul Barakat comes from a generation of awliya. Ala Hazrat comes from a generation of great awliya. Imam Ahl Sunnat radiallahu anhu comes from a generation of great awliya, great and pious, blessed personalities, like the father of Sayyidi Ala Hazrat, Imam al-Mutaqallimin, the great scholar of Ala Hazrat of Bareilly Sharif, Ala Hazrat's beloved father, Hazrat Allama Naqi Ali Khan radiallahu ta'ala anhu, very, very great Imam. So knowledgeable and so wise. Let me tell you that just one thing, on Surah Alam Nashrah, he wrote a commentary that goes into many hundred pages, just on the commentary of Surah Alam Nashrah. Can you understand the amount of knowledge that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon this personality, the father of Sayyidi Ala Hadrat radiallahu anhu, that just on Surah Alam Nashrah, hundreds of pages written in the commentary of Surah Alam Nashrah. Okay? And if you look at his discussions on the Mawlud of Rasulullah Pak sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you will be lost in love when he, in his beautiful work, Surur al-Qulub, Bidhikr al-Mahbub, drowned in the love of Rasulullah Akram Nuri Mujassam sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ala Hazrat's grandfather, Hazrat Raza Ali Khan, radiallahu ta'ala an, was a very great budurg of his time. Very pious personality spent, and a very great mystique and a very great Sufi. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. So this Imam of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, today I want to, every day we pay tribute to Ala Hadrat Azimul Barakat in some way or the other. We pay tribute to Ala Hadrat by rendering Mustafa Jani Rahmat Pilaf Salam, the beautiful salam he wrote at the court of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sometimes we pay tribute by reciting the beautiful naat that he wrote in the praise of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sometimes with the beautiful manaqib which he wrote in the praise of Ghawse Pak and the awliya ikram, Ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhi majma'in. The beautiful words that he said about the companions, the noble companions of the beloved Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ridwanullahi ta'ala majma'in. So some way or the other, by reading the books of Ala Hadrat or passing the message of Ala Hadrat. And alhamdulillah, this is one of the personalities in the dunya that every single day there is a need for Ala Hadrat Azimul Barakat radiallahu. Every day of your life there is a need for Ala Hadrat Azimul Barakat radiallahu, because this is the fadilat that he has been blessed with from the court of Allah and from the beloved Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is the love that Sarkari Ghawsiyat Nabs and the Shaykh Abdul Qadir al-Jilani radiallahu anhu, and Khaja Khajagan, Khaja Mu'inuddin Chishti Ajmeri Sanjari radiallahu anhu, and all the awliya Allah have for Sarkari Ala Hadrat radiallahu anhu, that they have put him forward as their representative and to respond on their behalf spiritually and academically. And this is what Sayyidi Ala Hadrat radiallahu anhu did. Ala Hadrat, as I said, was born on the 10th of Shawwal, 1272 Hijri, and Ala Hadrat Azimul Barakat radiallahu ta'ala's birth alone was a blessed occasion. Ala Hadrat radiallahu ta'ala's birth alone was a blessed occasion. He's coming into this dunya. Allah sent him in this dunya as a ni'mat to the Muslims. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Ala Hadrat as a gift to the Muslim ummah. Do you know, on the day of the aqiqah of Ala Hadrat radiallahu ta'ala, when the aqiqah was being done, was being performed of Ala Hadrat radiallahu anhu, his blessed grandfather saw a wonderful dream on the day of aqiqah. And the interpretation of the dream was what? That this child, in other words, Ala Hadrat Azimul Barakat radiallahu anhu, will be a great scholar of deen and an arif. He will be a saintly and blessed personality. This is the Ala Hadrat radiallahu anhu, who at the age of four years old, he completed the recitation of the Holy Quran. 4 years old, he completed the recitation of the Holy Quran. This is that Ala Hadrat Imam Ahl Sunnah radiallahu anhu, subhanallah, such a great Imam. I'll tell you more in a little while. I'm sure we all know a lot about Ala Hadrat. Whatever I'm going to tell you may not be anything new, but we are sharing about this great Imam because of whom today our Iman is mazboot. Today our Iman is strong and our Iman is safe by the grace of Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is because of the karam of Ala Hadrat radiallahu anhu, who attached us to the court. Ala Hadrat is the one who attached us to Khwaja Ghareeb al-Nawaz. Ala Hadrat is the one who attached us to Ghawsi Azam. Ala Hadrat is the one who attached us to Baba Fariduddin. Ala Hadrat is the one who attached us to Hazrat Makhdoom Semna. Ala Hadrat is the one who attached us to Mahrera Muqaddasa and Sayyidina Shah Ali Rasul Mahrerwi radiallahu anhu, Hazrat Shah Barkatullah, Hazrat Shah Abdul Wahid Balgirami, Hazrat Sayyidina Ahmad Kalfi. All these great akad Hazrat Sayyidina Ibrahim Erji, Hazrat Sayyidina Sabir Ali Ahmad Alauddin Kalyani, all these great Budurgan Deen, Ala Hadrat radiallahu anhu is the one who attached us to them in this zamana. Ala Hadrat is the one who attached us to the doorpost of the Sahaba of the beloved Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Ala Hadrat is the one who brought us in the Qadmi Naz of Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. This is the personality that we are paying tribute to. Ala Hadrat Azimul Barakat radiallahu ta'ala an, subhanallah. Ala Hadrat Adimul Barkat radiallahu an, it is in the Malfuz Sharif that Ala Hadrat radiallahu an, that once there was a discussion regarding the dates of birth, and based on this he said, praise be to Allah, the date of my birth can be found in this blessed verse. Which verse? The verse that I recited to you. Ulaika kataba fi qulubihimul imana wa ayyadahum bi ruhim minh. These are those in whose hearts Almighty Allah has embedded iman. Ulaika kataba fi qulubihimul imana. These are those in whose hearts Allah has embedded iman, and from Himself He blessed them with assistance through the pure spirit. If you look at this verse of the Holy Quran and you add the numerical value of the alphabets in it, you will get the year of the birth of Ala Hazrat Imam Ahl Sunnat radiallahu ta'ala an. And then he recited the verse 22 of Surah Mujadila, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that you will not find those who believe in Allah and in the last day befriending those who oppose Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, even though if they are their fathers, their sons, their in other words their children, their brothers or their fellow tribesmen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states in the Holy Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Mujadila, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ala Hadrat recited that share. I am being brief. And then Ala Hadrat radiallahu anhu said after that, subhanallah, he said, all praise is due to Allah. I have always had hatred for those who are the enemies of Almighty Allah. I have always had hatred for those who are the enemies of Almighty Allah right from my childhood. And Alhamdulillah, Allah Hazrat said, Alhamdulillah, my children and my children's children have been blessed with this hatred for the enemies of Allah from the very beginning. And Alhamdulillah, this promise too has been fulfilled. Subhanallah. In other words, this blessed verse of the Holy Quran, the gift of those blessed and the manifestation of those blessed ayats Allah Hazrat is speaking about in his own life. And he further said, reciting أُولَٰئِكَ كَتَبَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمُ الْإِيمَانَ وَأَيَّدَهُمْ بِرُوحٍ مِّنْ. What does he say? He said, praise be to Allah. Alhamdulillah, if my heart has to be split into two pieces, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Ala Hadrat radiallahu anhu says, if my heart has to be split into two pieces, if the heart of Ahmad Raza has to be split into two pieces, then by Allah, Qasam Khudaki, by Allah, one part of my heart you will find inscribed La ilaha illallah, and on the other part of my heart you will find inscribed Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Subhanallah, what an ashik azar. This is a personality who was absorbed and drowned in the love of Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was drowned completely in the love of Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he himself is saying that if my heart has to be split into two, on one side will be La ilaha illallah and on the other side will be Muhammadur Rasulullah. Think about it. Think about the love and the maqam of this great Imam. Think about his closeness in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And let me tell you, we're going on saying Imam Ahl Sunnah, Imam Ahmad Raza. Indeed, Ala Hadrat is the Imam of the Ahl Sunnah. Indeed, Ala Hadrat is our Imam. Ala Hadrat Adhimul Barakat radiallahu anhu, as I said, he attached us to all these pious persons. He attached us to all the awliya, and these awliya complimented him by making him their representative to protect the iman of the Muslims in the dunya, to protect the aqidah of the Ahle Sunnat wal Jama'at. I've said this before, okay, many people have tried to remove the name of Ala Hazrat from the hearts of the Ummah. Many people have tried to remove the love of Ala Hazrat Alimul Barakat from the dunya. Many have tried to basically dig the name of Ala Hazrat out of the hearts of the believers, but you cannot do it because it is already embedded. It is already engraved. The love of Ala Hazrat is already engraved. The love of Ala Hazrat is already embedded in our hearts. Why? Because Ala Hazrat radiallahu's heart is embedded the love of Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam. If his heart is split in two, he says, on one side is La ilaha illallah, on the other side is Muhammadur Rasulullah, meaning that his heart, in it is embedded and engraved the love of Allah and the manifestation and the blessing of Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam. That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and by His grace and His mercy and by the blessing of His Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, embedded the name of Ala Hadrat and the love of Ala Hadrat in the hearts of billions of people throughout the world. Whether you go from the east to the west, whether you go to from India, you start at India from Bareilly Sharif, you go to Ajmer Sharif, you go to Kalyar Sharif, you go to Mahrara Sharif, you go to Baghdad Sharif, you go to any Mubarak Barga in the world, you go to any country in the world, you will definitely find somebody who knows who is Imam Ahl Sunnah. You will definitely find somebody who knows Ala Hazrat Adhimul Barakat. And amazingly, subhanallah, blessing, a very great blessing, that you will go into places where you think that there is none who knows, but there you will suddenly hear the echo one day of Mustafa Jaan Rahmat, Pilakho Salam, Shama'i Bazmi Hidayat, Pilakho Salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed him for his deep love for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. No matter who and whichever mission or group or sect or cult tries to remove the love of Ala Hadrat Adhimul Barakat and from the hearts of the people, and tries to weaken the manner and the way of Ala Hadrat, they cannot do it, because the way of Ala Hadrat cannot be weakened, because this is the way of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah. This is the way of the awliya. This is the way of the Aimmah Mujtahideen. This is the way of the Tabi Tabi'een. This is the way of the Tabi'een. This is the way of the Sahaba Ikram. And this is the way of Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And this is Deen. This is Deen. This is it. Maslake Ala Hadrat radiallahu anhu is the name and the recognition of true deen in this zamana. It is the recognition of the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that this is the correct way. That is why Huzur Sayyidi wa Murshadi Sarkare Taju Sharia Rahbar Tariqat Hadrat Allama Maulana Imam Mufti Akhtar Rida Khan radiallahu anhu says, ki maslake Ala Hadrat pe qaim raho. Maslake Ala Hadrat pe qaim raho. Zindagi di gayi hai isi ke liye. Zindagi di gayi hai isi ke liye. Zindagi di gayi hai isi ke liye. Ala Hadrat Adhimul Barakat's name, no matter how much people have tried, they could not erase it. Do you know why? Because Ahmad Raza ka taza gulistan hai aaj bhi. Just like Ala Hadrat's, the gardens of Ala Hadrat's love were blooming yesterday, today they are blooming and blossoming as well. Ahmad Raza ka taza gulistan hai aaj bhi. Khurshid ilm unka darakhsha hai aaj bhi. The sun of his knowledge is shining bright even today. Khurshid ilm unka darakhsha hai aaj bhi. Sab unse jalne walo ke gul ho gaye chiragh. The flames of all those who burnt in his animosity and jealousy have been extinguished. Sab unse jalne walo ke gul ho gaye chiragh. Ahmad Raza ka shama farauza hai aaj bhi. And the flame of the love of Ala Hazrat is radiant even today. Ahmad Raza ka taza gulista hai aaj bhi. Khurshid ilm unka darakhsha hai aaj bhi. Sab unse jalne walo ke gul ho gaye chiragh. Ahmad Raza ka shama farauza hai aaj bhi. And remember that he is our imam. If anybody asks, who is your imam? My imam is Imam Ahl Sunnat. Because when you accept Ala Hadrat as your imam, as your mujaddid, then subhanallah, Hawse Azam radiallahu anhu accepts you. Khaja Gharibun Nawaz accepts you. Hadrat Sabir Pak accepts you. Hadrat Sayyidina Baba Fariduddin Ganj Shakra accepts you. Hadrat Data Ganj Baksh Lahori Hajveri radiallahu anhu accepts you. Hadrat Sayyidina Bayezid Bustami accepts you. Hadrat Sayyidina Maruf Karhi accepts you. Hadrat Sayyidina Shahabuddin Soharwardi accepts you. Hadrat Sayyidina Bayezid Bustami and his great Mashaykh accept you. Hadrat Sayyidina Hawse Azam Jilani al-Baghdadi accepts you. Hadrat Sayyidina Imam Azam Abu Hanifa accepts you. Hadrat Sayyidina Siddiq Akbar accepts you. Hadrat Umar Farooq accepts you. Usman Ghani accepts you. Maula Ali accepts you. And Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam accepts you. Because the Ala Hadrat Adimul Barkat radiallahu ta'ala an is the representative of the court of the beloved Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the rightly appointed representative from the court of the beloved Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for the protection of the deen of the Muslims and for the iman of the Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'at. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed him with this maqam and this fazilah, his knowledge and his piety. Even as a child, subhanallah, was amazing. You look at Ala Hadrat, we didn't get to see Ala Hadrat. I didn't see Ala Hadrat. You didn't see Ala Hadrat. But subhanallah, we got to see the reflection of Ala Hadrat. The reflection of Ala Hadrat, those who saw Hujjatul Islam saw his reflection in him. Those who saw Huzur Mufti Azam Hind saw his reflection in him. Those who saw Huzur Mufti Azam saw his reflection, saw Huzur Sayyidi Taj Sharia radiallahu anhu, and all these blessed awliya ikram radiallahu anhu ajma'in, they saw his reflection in him, and we saw Ala Hadrat's reflection indeed in Huzur Sayyidi Taj Sharia radiallahu anhu. And we are seeing it, alhamdulillah, in Huzur Qaida Millat. We are seeing it in Huzur Sayyidi Muhaddith Kabir. Do you know why? Because they represent the mission of Ala Hadrat Adimul Barkat radiallahu ta'ala an. And Allahu Akbar, talking, people want to talk about Ala Hadrat's maqam, Ala Hadrat's knowledge, Ala Hadrat's wisdom, Ala Hadrat's acumen. Allahu Akbar, that Imam who was a master, who was a master in more than 54 different sciences of knowledge, that Imam who wrote more than 1,200 books and treatises in his life, of which one book alone is almost 30,000 pages, Fatawa Razviya Sharif. That Imam who in a few hours wrote Ad-Dawlatul Maqiyya bil Maddatil Ghaybiyya on the Ilm al-Ghayb of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the Arabic language. That great Imam, Ala Hadrat Alimul Barkat, radiallahu ta'ala an, who was a scientist, he was an astronomer, he was a philosopher, he was a mathematician. You name it, Ala Hadrat radiallahu an was in that scientific, mathematical, theoretical field. Every field, Ala Hadrat was a psychologist, Ala Hadrat was a physiologist, Ala Hadrat Azimul Barkat was a geomorphologist. But let me tell you what else Ala Hadrat was. This was dunya that I'm telling you about. Ala Hadrat radiallahu an is a muhaddith, Ala Hadrat is a muballigh, Ala Hadrat is a mufassir, Ala Hadrat is the faqih adam of his zamana, and Ala Hadrat is the ashiq rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and Ala Hadrat is the miracle of the blessed miracles of Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But people want to know about Ala Hadrat. If you want to know about Ala Hadrat dur ki baat hai. First look at the khulafa of Ala Hadrat. Learn who the khulafa of Ala Hadrat was. Go and look at Huzur Sayyidi Sadru Sharia, Badru Tariqa, the father of Huzur Sayyidi Muhaddith Kabir, subhanallah. Indeed, the fruit does not fall far from the tree. Indeed, from a beautiful and fresh tree, you will get lovely and lush fruit and beautiful, luscious, delicious fruit. Subhanallah. Huzur Sadru Sharia. Look at the khulafa. You want to talk? We want to talk about Ala Hazrat. Look at the Khulafa. Look at Huzur Sadru Sharia. And if you want to look at Huzur Sadru Sharia without looking at anything else, look at Huzur Muhaddith Kabir. If you want to look at Huzur Sadru Sharia, how do you look at the reflection of Huzur Sadru Sharia? Look at Huzur Sadru Sharia's reflection in Huzur Muhaddith Kabir. If this is the shan of the son of Huzur Sadru Sharia, this is the shan of the son of the Khalifa of Ala Hadrat, that he has knowledge of more than 60,000 hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and in 88 years of his life has been teaching Bukhari Sharif for more than half a century. Then think about it, that if this is the maqam and the fadilat of the son of the Khalifa of Ala Hadrat, then what must be the shan of the Khalifa of Ala Hadrat who wrote Bahari Shariat? What must be the shan of the Khalifa of Ala Hadrat who would sit and be one of the scribes at the court of Ala Hadrat Adimul Barkat, and who would be the personality who Ala Hadrat radiallahu anhu had etabar and trust on? What can you say about that personality? And if that is the shan of the Sadru Sharia, if that is the shan of Sadru Sharia, then what must be the maqam of that person in whose court Sadru Sharia became Sadru Sharia? You want to talk about Ala Hadrat, and then come back to his Khulafa. Go to Madinatul Munawwara. Hijra, and look at Qutb Madina, Hazrat Sayyidina Shaykh Ziauddin Madani radiallahu ta'ala an. You want to know about Ala Hazrat? Go to Qutb Madina. This is that Qutb Madina, that Imam of his Zamana, the love that he had for Ala Hazrat living in Madina, the love he had, that when somebody would come to become murid of him in the presence of Huzur Sayyidi wa Sanadi Sarkari Mufti Azam Hind, who is the son of Ala Hazrat radiallahu an, what he would say? He would say, become murid of him, for he's my Shaykh, he's my Murshid. And when they would ask, that not your Murshid, it is the son of your Murshid, he would say, the son of my Shaykh is my Shaykh, the son of my Murshid is my Murshid. And this is that Qutb Madina. He was, his piety, everybody knew. His taqwa and his steadfastness, everybody knew. Allahu Akbar. When the Qutb of Madina of the era is the Khalifa of Ala Hazrat radiallahu an, so can you imagine what is the shan of the of that great Shaykh Ala Hazrat Adimul Barakat radiallahu an, Malikul Ulama, Hazrat Allama Zafruddin Bihari radiallahu an, the Imam who wrote volumes on the life of Ala Hazrat, a master mathematician, a master in so many different sciences of knowledge. You look at the knowledge and the wisdom of Sayyidina Malikul Ulama radiallahu ta'ala an, and you are astounded, and you start to say that this is Malikul Ulama, this is wisdom, this is his writing, this is his knowledge, this is his shan. And you start to say, but where did Malikul Ulama become Malikul Ulama? Malikul Ulama became Malikul Ulama at the feet of Ala Hazrat Adimul Barakat radiallahu ta'ala an. Go to another Khalifa of Ala Hazrat, Sadrul Afadil, Allama Sayyid Naimuddin Muradabadi radiallahu ta'ala an. Sadrul Afadil, amongst the heads and the chiefs of the great scholars, he was known as Sadrul Afadil, Allama Naimuddin Muradabadi radiallahu ta'ala an's maqam, his fazilat, Allahu Akbar. One thing, one of his works is sufficient, Khazainul Irfan, which is the commentary written on Kanzul Iman, the translation of the Holy Quran by Ala Hazrat radiallahu an. You start to say, ki Sadrul Afadil ki ye shan hai. This is the maqam of Sadrul Afadil, such a wise personality, such a blessed personality, such a knowledgeable personality, such a pious personality, Sadrul Afadil, that person who was known as the chief of the scholars. I want to ask that where did Sadrul Afadil become Sadrul Afadil? He became Sadrul Afadil at the feet of Ala Hazrat Adimul Barakat radiallahu ta'ala an. Today the world talks about the roving ambassador of Islam. They talk about the roving ambassador of Islam. The world prides itself on the roving ambassador of Islam, in his eloquence of speech, in his manner of writing, in his debating qualities. The world prides itself at Maulana Hazrat Allama Maulana Abdul Alim Siddiqui Mirti radiallahu anhu, Muballigh Islam. And the world says that we never see, people of Africa say that none has seen in this country a personality like Muballigh Islam. People of Fiji and Europe and other countries say that we have not seen somebody like Muballigh Islam and his wisdom and his acumen. Let me tell you something. Where did Muballigh Islam become Muballigh Islam? Where did Muballigh Islam become Muballigh Islam? He became Muballigh Islam at the feet of Ala Hadrat Adimul Barakat radiallahu ta'ala. And do you know what he said about his Shaykh? Do you know what Muballigh Islam said? He said, Tumhari shan mein jo kuch kahun, usse siwa tum ho, qaseem jaan irfa ae shahe Ahmad Raza tum ho, gharik behre ulfat, mast jaam baadae وحدت محب خاص منظور حبیب کبریا تم ہو, جو مرکز ہے شریعت کا مدار اہل طریقت کا, جو محور ہے حقیقت کا وہ قطب الاولیاء تم ہو. And what did he say? یہاں آ کر ملے نہرے شریعت اور طریقت کی, ہے سینہ مجمع البحرین ایسا رہنما تم ہو, حرم والوں نے مانا تم کو اپنا قبلہ و کعبہ, جو قبلہ اہل قبلہ کا ہے وہ قبلہ نما تم ہو. سبحان اللہ. And so many other beautiful words. حضرت سیدنا مولانا عبدالعلیم صدیقی, the roving ambassador, says about his Murshid Kamil, about Huzur Ala Hazrat. And you know what he says? He says, Bhikari tere dar ka bheek ke jholi hai phailaye, Bhikari tere dar ka bheek ke jholi hai phailaye, Bhikari ko ki bharo jholi, gada ka asara tum ho, Ali ne khasta ek adna gada hai aastane ka. That Abdul Alim Siddiqui, who the world calls the roving ambassador of Islam, he says that I am a humble and a weak and the lowest beggar at the court of Ala Hadrat Adimul Barakat. He says to Ala Hadrat when saying his praise and reading tahniyat and mankabat in his place, he says, Ali ne khasta ek adna gada hai aastane ka, karam farmane wale hal par uske shaha tum ho. Now you're talking about this. Look what he is saying about Ala Hadrat. People want to talk about Abdul Alim Siddiqui. Look at what he said about his great Shaykh Sayyidi Ala Hadrat radiallahu anhu. Going to the court of another Khalifa of Ala Hadrat, Shaykh Ahl Sunnat, Hadrat Allama Maulana Hashmat Ali Khan, Rahmatullahi Ta'ala Alayh. People talk about his munazara. People talk about his debating skill. People talk about his wisdom. People talk about his intellect. Where did he become Shaykh Ahl Sunnah? At the feet of Ala Hazrat radiallahu anhu. People talk about Hazrat Allama, Maulana Mufti Mahmud Jan Peshawari radiallahu anhu. His knowledge. Look at his books like Ilahi Sunnat. Look at his Zikr Raza. Look at his wisdom. And look at his Khandan today. You will find chiraz of the Ahl Sunnah present in it. Where did Mufti Mahmud Jan Peshawari radiallahu anhu become Mahmud Jan? Where did he become Allama Mahmud Jan? At the Qadam of Ala Hazrat, in the feet of Ala Hazrat radiallahu anhu, and go into the court of Hazrat Burhan Millat, Hazrat Burhan Din Jabalpuri radiallahu anhu. Allahu Akbar. Pekar Taqwa, a personality who was soaked in Taqwa, a personality who was known as Burhan of the Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, the Burhan and the argument and the dalil and the lamp of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'at. Where did Burhan and Millat become Burhan and Millat? At the sacred feet of Sayyidina Sarkari Ala Hadrat Adimul Barakat radiallahu anhu. And subhanallah, Muhaddis Kachochwi, Hadrat Muhaddis Azam Hind radiallahu ta'ala an. Where did he get this maqam? Look at his wisdom, look at his piety, look at what he says about Ala Hadrat, look at what he says about Hudur Mufti Azam. Go back in history and you'll see. But where did Muhaddis Azam become Muhaddis Azam? In the court of Ala Hadrat Adimul Barakat radiallahu ta'ala. Think about what the great scholars have said. Think about, we want to talk about Ala Hadrat. First go in the qadam, in the feet of the khulafa of Ala Hadrat. Think, as I said, Qudbe Madina became Qudbe Madina through the blessing of Ala Hadrat. Sadrul Afadil became Sadrul Afadil in the qadam of Ala Hadrat. Sadrul Sharia became Sadrul Sharia in the sacred feet of Ala Hadrat. Hazrat Shaykh Shahil Sunnat became Shaykh Shahil Sunnat in the feet of Ala Hadrat. Muballigh Islam became Muballigh Islam in the feet of Ala Hadrat radiallahu ta'ala. Hadrat Sayyidina Muhaddis Azam Hind radiallahu became Muhaddis Azam Hind radiallahu in the court of Ala Hadrat Adimul Barakat radiallahu ta'ala. All these great personalities became what they are in the sadqa of Ala Hadrat radiallahu because of the nazar karam of Ala Hadrat. So if this is the shan of Sadrul Afadil, if this is the shan of Qudbi Madina, if this is the shan of Allama Mahmud Jan, if this is the shan of Hadrat Shaykh Shaykh Ahl Sunnah, if this is the shan of Hadrat Malikul Ulama, if this is the shan of Sadrul Afadil, if this is the shan of Burhan Millat, then what is the shan of Ala Hadrat Imam Ahl Sunnat, Ash-Shah Imam Ahmad Raza Khan, Fazil Barelvi radiallahu ta'ala an, Ahmad Raza ka taza, gulista hai aaj bhi, khurshid ilm unka, darakhsha hai aaj bhi, sagun se jalne walo ki gul ho gaye chira, Ahmad Raza ki shamha firoza hai aaj bhi. Ala Hadrat is that personality who when he stood up, when nobody was standing up, Ala Hadrat Adimul Barakat radiallahu an, stood up for the sake of the protection of the deen of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ala Hadrat radiallahu ta'ala an stood up for the firmness of the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he fought the enemy of Rasul-e-Pak sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. He fought the enemy of the awliya Allah. Ala Hadrat stood up and he said, Kilke razai khanjare khukhan barkabar, aada se kehdo khair manaye na shar kare. Ala Hadrat Adimul Barakat radiallahu ta'ala an, is that Ala Hadrat that when he stood against the bad mazhabs? Because Ala Hadrat stands in that zamana, today we are able to go to the mazar of Sultanul Hind with pride. Today we are able to go to Baghdad al-Muqaddas with pride. Today we are able to put chadars on the mazarat of the awliya. Today we are able to put flowers on the graves of our parents. Today we are able to put to make the Fatiha and the niyaz of the pious servants of Allah, because Ala Hadrat Adimul Barakat defended these stances, and Ala Hadrat gave the dalil of this, and he stood against them. That is why Hazrat Sayyidi Alan Abdul Alim Siddiqui Mirti radiallahu anhu says, Jalalo Haybat Farooq Azam aap se zahir. Jalalo Haybat Farooq Azam aap se zahir. Zahir Aduullah par ek harba. Subhanallah. This is Ala Hadrat Adimul Barakat radiallahu ta'ala an. This is the personality who we are talking about and whom we are paying tribute to. What else do you want me to say about Ala Hadrat? We can talk hours and hours about Ala Hadrat radiallahu ta'ala an. People in the Ala Hadrat stood so firm against them. We must learn from the life of Ala Hadrat. Today when we stand firm for Maslaki Ala Hadrat, today when we try to be steadfast Maslaki Ala Hadrat, we do not say we are the steadfast ones. We say we are trying and we are attempting, and we are relying on the mercy of Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the karam of the awliya and the mashayikh, and the blessing and the nazar karam of Ala Hadrat and our mashayikh, that we may remain firm on Mazhab Ahl Sunnah and Maslaki Ala Hadrat. But today when we stand firm, and when somebody says a little bit something to us, or somebody insults us, or somebody swears at us, or somebody speaks or criticizes us because of our firmness or because of our efforts to be firm on Maslaki Ala Hadrat, then sometimes we take we take it seriously in the sense that we become hurt, we become sad, we become broken, because we say that how we are trying to be hard, but look at the firm for the sake of deen. But what, why is somebody saying this to me? Maybe I should just not do this anymore. Maybe I should not stand up and be firm. Let me join the rest of the people. Don't ever do that. Don't ever do that. Remain firm. Remain firm on Maslaki Ala Hazrat. Maslaki Ala Hazrat is the right way. Maslaki Ala Hazrat is the way of the pious servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Maslaki Ala Hazrat pe qaim raho. Zindagi di gayi hai isi ke liye. Make this your ta'weez and naqsh in your heart. Maslaki Ala Hazrat pe qaim raho. Zindagi di gayi hai isi ke liye. And let me tell you, Ala Hazrat radiallahu anhu, you think people didn't criticize Ala Hazrat? Till today they are criticizing and trying to find faults in Ala Hazrat. Magar all those who looked for faults, kabar mein pahunch gaye, khatam ho gaye. Ala Hazrat ka naam aaj bhi roshan hai. Ahmad Raza ka taza gulistan hai aaj bhi. Khurshid ilm unka tarakhsha hai aaj bhi. Sab unse jalne walo ke gul ho gaye chiraag. Ahmad Raza ki shama firoza hai aaj bhi. Ala Hazrat Imam Ahl Sunnat Imam Ahmad Raza Khan radiallahu anhu, also people in his zamana, they slandered him. They wrote letters against him. They wrote documents against Ala Hazrat radiallahu anhu. They would swear Ala Hazrat in letters. Today if somebody does that to us, make shukr. If we are doing it for the sake of Haq and somebody is doing that to us, thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we got this jalwa of Ala Hazrat on us. That if it is happening to us, subhanallah, alhamdulillah, if it is for the pleasure of Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There were those sectors who wrote slanderous letters to Sayyidi Ala Hazrat. Consisted of vulgarism, slander. Once a person sent such a letter which contained very harsh and vulgar words, Malikul Ulama, Malikul Ulama, Hadrat Allama Zafruddin Bihari radiallahu anhu says that he read a few lines of the letter and he put it aside and said that some Wahhabi has sent proof of his mischief. Present there was a murid who had not so long ago become murid of Sayyidi Ala Hadrat. He picked up the letter and started to read it. Coincidentally, the name and address written on the letter, whether it was the correct information or not, belonged to someone who was from the same city as this new murid. The murid became very anguished. He became very aggrieved. What gham ho gaya unko? He remained silent for a little while. But when Sayyidi Ala Hazrat radhiyallahu anhu entered the chambers, the house after Maghrib, he stopped Sayyidi Ala Hazrat and said, when he was about to enter his private chambers, the letter which I was reading, which Maulana Zafruddin read a few lines of and then put it aside, was written by some terrible person. And the entire letter consists of vulgarism and slander. He then said, I feel that we should put a case against him so that he may be punished and so that it may serve as a warning to others, as a deterrence, who try to do the same. If not, others will follow suit and do the same. Sayyidi Ala Hazrat radiallahu anhu, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Sayyidi Ala Hazrat radiallahu anhu said to him, come and sit down for a bit. Come here, sit down for a bit. Sayyidi Ala Hazrat radhiyallahu anhu then went into his house and he returned with a pack of letters, 10 or 15 letters in his hand. He handed them to the new murid and said, read these. Those present were a bit confused as to what those letters contained, but all assumed that they were similar letters which contained slanderous remarks. And Sayyidi Ala Hazrat that asked him to read them so that he may understand that this was nothing new, but it was something which has been happening for some time now. However, this did not seem like the case, because the man, while reading the letters, as he went through them, his face lit up. Chehra roshan ho gaya. His face lit up with happiness. Khushi ke asar unke chehre pe nazar aane lage. His face lit up with happiness and excitement. After he had completed reading all those letters, that pack stack of letters which Ala Hazrat gave him, Ala Hazrat radhiyallahu anhu then looked at him and said, first, let's reward those who have sung our praises, or those who set the bar for this praise, with honor, respect, properties, gifts as a token of appreciation for their kindness. And thereafter, we think about punishing those who have slandered us. First, let's reward them with honor and praise and gifts for all those who wrote this. Then we think about those who slandered us. The person, the murid, was amazed and said, not only do I wish to reward them, those who wrote such praises about you, I would love to reward and benefit the generations to come for the beauty of what they wrote, but unfortunately I am not in the position to do. Sayyidi Ala Hazrat Adimul Barakat radiallahu anhu said, when the sincere and loyal cannot be rewarded, then let's leave the detractors alone as well. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. This is Ala Hazrat Adimul Barakat radiallahu anhu. This is Imam Ahl Sunnat radiallahu. It is mentioned that there is a place in India, in Bihar, and once the Sunnis of that area, I think it's called Rajhat or Rajhat, invited Hazrat Maulana Qari Baksh Sahib, Shah Sarami, there to deliver a discourse. After the lecture, when everyone sat down to eat, someone asked him, "Maulana, how can we recognize someone to be a Sunni or a Wahhabi? What is the sign of recognition? There should be some method by which we too understand, and which is very simple, from which we may be able to differentiate. It should not be some intense point based on deep knowledge. Something simple for us laymen to understand." He said, "I will tell you a very easy, beneficial and effective code, that to find anything better than it will be difficult. If you are in doubt as to whether a person is a Sunni or a Wahhabi or a Bad Mazhab, then talk about Maulana Ahmad Raza Khan Barelvi in his presence. And while doing so, look at his face carefully. If you find the signs of excitement and happiness on his face and joy, then know that he is certainly a Sunni. And if you observe signs of dejection and resentment, then know he is a Wahhabi, he is a deviant, he is a Bad Mazhab. And if he is not a Wahhabi, then surely he has some kind of deviance in him." And subhanallah, he said, in this era, the sign in this refers to say to Imam Ahmad Raza Barelvi. Because in reality, all those who are from the Ahl Sunnah praise Ala Hadrat and are his true devotees, and they sincerely love him. And he said, none will love him but a true believer, and none will resent him but a hypocrite. This is the manifestation which is in Ala Hadrat Adimul Barakat radiallahu ta'ala of the beloveds. And subhanallah, this was the same method that the ulama of Makkatul Mukarrama and Medina Munawwara used in the time of Ala Hadrat. That when somebody went to them, they would first ask, "Do you know Imam Maulana Ahmad Raza or Imam Ahmad Raza?" And when they would say, "Yes, we know him," and they would become pleased, then they would say, "These people are from Ahl Sunnah." In this zamana, let me tell you, if you want to know who are firm on Maslaki Ala Hadrat, who are the true representatives of Maslaki Ala Hadrat, then subhanallah, take the name of Huzur-e Ala Hadrat's beloved, Huzur-e Taj Sharia in front of them. Take the name of Huzur-e Muhaddith-e Kabir in front of them and look at their faces. From that you will know ki kitne paani mein hai and what is their condition, whether they truly follow the way of Ala Hadrat or they just say they follow the way of Ala Hadrat but they're not following that way. Think about it. Hold firm to the pious servants of Allah. Hold firm to the way of Ala Hadrat Adimul Barakat radiallahu ta'ala an. Ala Hadrat Adimul Barakat is indeed our Imam. Ala Hadrat Adimul Barakat's love for Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam has no bounds. It showed us how to love Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And that is why today we all say, ki dal di qalb mein azmat-e Mustafa, dal di qalb mein azmat-e Mustafa, Sayyidi Ala Hadrat Pilaku Salam, Shaykh Najdi Kasar, kaat kar rakh diya, Shaykh Najdi Kasar, kaat kar rakh diya, Khanjare Ala Hadrat Pelakho Salam, Khanjare Ala Hadrat Pelakho Salam. And the poet said beautifully, ki kalame raza haqq khanjar hai logo. When you read a kalam in any mahfil, when you read Ala Hadrat's kalam, the rang is different. And if there are any people sitting there that are muzabzab and those are jumping from one end to another, when you read Ala Hadrat's kalam, you will see that how they become restless and nervous. And when you see the ushak sitting in the court and you read the kalam of Ala Hadrat, you will see how they become excited and jubilant. And then that is why the poet says, subhanallah, use this as your test also. The kalam of Ala Hadrat, what does he say? Subhanallah, he says, kalam-e-raza haqq khanjar hai logo, girata hai batil ka sar kar dekhte hai, aur kalam kar diye najdiyon ko ke saron ko, kalam kar diye najdiyon ke saron ko, kalam mein ye tere asar dekhte hai. And if we follow the way of Ala Hadrat, if we follow the way of the awliya, if we follow the way of the beloveds of Allah, then what will happen when we die and when we're leaving this world? Then lahad mein ishq rukh shah ka daag leke chale, lahad mein ishq rukh shah ka daag leke chale, andheri raat suni thi chiraag leke chale. And how will you get it? By attaching yourself to the awliya, tere ghulamo, by attaching yourself to the sahaba, by attaching yourself to the ahle bayt, by attaching yourself in the court of the beloved Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And how will you get this? Tere ghulamo ka naqsh qadam hai raah e khuda, tere ghulamo ka naqsh qadam hai raah e khuda, wo kya bhatak sake, wo kya bahak sake, jo ye suraag leke chale. Tere ghulamo ka naqsh qadam hai raah e khuda, wo kya bahak sake, jo ye suraag leke chale. And I'm ending today with the shares, two or three of the shares again, subhanallah, of the roving ambassador of Islam, Hazrat Maulana Abdullah Nim Siddiqui Mirti rahmatullahi ta'ala alayh, ke tumhari shaan mein jo kuch kahun usse siwa tum ho. O Ala Hazrat, what more can I say about you? What more can we say about you? Tumhari shaan mein jo kuch kahun usse siwa tum ho, qaseem-e-jaam-e-irfa, aish-e-ahle-bayt, احمد رضا تم ہو, غریق بحر الفت مست جام میں باد آئے وحدت, غریق بحر الفت مست جام میں باد آئے وحدت, محب خاص منظور حبیب کبیر کبریا تم ہو. تم جو مرکز ہے شریعت کا, مدار اہل طریقت کا, جو محور ہے حقیقت کا, وہ قطب الاولیاء تم ہو. یہاں آ کر ملے نہر شریعت اور طریقت کی, سینہ مجمع البحرین ایسے رہنما تم ہو. علیم خستہ ایک ادنا گدا ہے آستانے کا, کرم فرمانے والے حال پر اس کے شہا تم ہو. اینڈ فرام آور سائڈ دی سیم ورڈز آف مولانا عبدالعلیم صدیقی مرتی, بھکاری تیرے در کا بھیک کے جھولی ہے پھیلائے. او اعلی حضرت, بھکاری تیرے در کا, وی آر بیگرز اسپریڈنگ اور دامن ان یور کورٹ, بھکاری تیرے در کا بھیک کے جھولی ہے پھیلائے. بھکاری کی بھرو جھولی, بھکاری کی بھرو جھولی, بھکاری کی بھرو جھولی, گدا کا آسرا تم ہو. وما علینا الا البلاغ. السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ.